Hi guys, this is Ali Rator from TechWrath TV, and in this Unity's quick tutorial, I'm going to teach you how you can click the button, show that panel, close it, and switch between the panels by using just one script with few lines of code in your game. So stick around and we'll be back after this quick tutorial. Welcome back. So as you can see, my scene is pretty clear, it's pretty blank. What I'm going to do first off, I'm going to zoom in so you guys can see what I'm doing. So I'm going to create a canvas. This is for extreme beginners. So if those guys who've already done this, please be patient. And in canvas, I'm going to create a button again with UI, a button. I've used Text Message Pro. So this one is going to be pause button. I'm just going to give it a big width and a big height, and I'm going to change the text to pause. So most of you guys will have this one. I'm going to change the font. This is the font that I've already installed, so it becomes very prominent, right? And on the top, I'm going to give it 150. Oh, sorry. That's the text, but for the button, I'm going to give it 150. Let's give it 350. So the pause button has moved up, and I'm going to duplicate this button. You can do it by pressing Control D, letter D for dog, and it's going to create a new button. This is going to be info button, right? And in the info button, I'm going to change the text to info, and I'm going to take this button down to zero. If you go to my screen now, you'll see that we've got two buttons. So the idea is, if you press pause, it's going to show the pause panel. And if you're going to click info, it's going to show the info panel. Now, normally people do is like they make different functions, but I'm going to give you a file that's going to be called UI Panel Manager, which is a general file. You can either download it from our blog. I'm going to send the link down below, or you can type it if you want. Just pause the video and you can type it. So I'm going to do is, inside the panel, I'm going to right click UI and make a panel again. I'm going to make a panel. This one is going to be pause panel, right? I'm just going to change a bit of settings. The color I'm going to change to 2F2F2F, and I'm going to make this totally dark. So at least we know the panel is open. In the boss panel, I'm going to create another UI text. This is going to be called a heading. Sorry, it's renamed it. And in the heading, I'm going to call it pause heading. Right? Bear with me, those of you who have done this already, guys. We have to take everybody with us. So please be patient and no hard feelings. Right? So we've got this heading. This is the panel for pause panel. Again, press Control D, duplicate, F2, and we're going to call it information panel. And in the information panel heading, we are going to say information, right? I'm going to select another font. This is, you don't have to do it. It's just making, making it look good, cool. So you can. Guys, as well, how to do that as well. So information panel, I'm gonna uncheck, hide it, and for pause, pause is feeling a bit neglected though. So pause panel as well, we're gonna uncheck. And so basically your UI would have different buttons, could be information, would be settings button, stuff like that. What you need to do is, number one, select canvas, go to the scripts, have this UI panel, and drag it on the canvas. you'll have this script on canvas. Now coming to pause button, click it, then go to the drop down for buttons, scroll down again, guys, be patient, we have to take everybody with us. So on click, click the plus button and you'll see runtime online, and you'll have a empty section here. So all we need to do is grab, left click and grab the canvas, drag it on this section and drop it, and then you'll see it says no function here. Now click it and you'll see different sections here. Go to the bottom one which says UI panel manager, that's the file that we've created, and find the function that says show panel. So this is the function that says show panel, so click it. It's gonna ask you for the panel that you want to show once this button is clicked. So for pause panel, we created pause, sorry, for pause button, we created pause panel. Click it, drag it on top of this object. That's done. We're going to repeat the process for info button. In info button, I'm going to go same thing on click. You guys can repeat after me. Plus, drag the canvas element object on top of this. It's going to read the script. Select UI panel manager and then go to show panel. It's going to ask which panel to show, right? Info panel. That's right. We're going to drag it here. And that's what we have done. Now, in these panels, if we go to this panel, check it. You see, there's no back button. So all I'm going to do is right click on the panel UI, create a button. We're going to call it close button. So now you guys will get it. That in the games, we normally have a button where you just close. And I'm going to make it like go to 300. So we have this pause panel with the close button here. The close button, again with the close button text, we can say close. I'm going to select a font. And I'm going to increase the text. Now with the close button inside the pause panel, I'm gonna press Ctrl D to duplicate it and drag it to the next panel as well. So both the panels, now if I check this for information panel, it has a close button as well, you guys can see. And if I hide this, then in the pause panel we have a close button as well, so you can hide the pause panel as well. If you don't want to hide it, it's going to make it easier for you guys. So I'm going to click the close button now. Go to the button drop down. And we're going to repeat the same thing again. We're going to click plus. Drag the canvas. Go to the no function section, UI panel. Now this time we're going to choose. We're going to close. Hide panel function here. Like to close this panel, we need to select hide panel function, and now we're going to show it because it's in pause panel. We're going to tell it to close this panel, right? Now coming back to the close button, if it's unchecked even, that's fine. Close button 2, we're going to repeat the process. Drag the canvas, select the function UI manager, hide panel, and we're going to show it to hide the information panel, right? Now we're going to save it. And for pause panel for it to run, and this is a normal issue in Unity, you guys must have faced it as well. Pause panel, I'm gonna hide, but this is your screen, and I'm gonna zoom out, right? So we're gonna click play, and my simulator, I've set up the simulator as well. So now if you click pause, it's gonna show you a pause panel. And you can have different options here as well. If you click close, it will close this panel. If you click the information one, it's going to show you the information panel. So by this script, just by using one script and just dragging the functions, you can have like information credits here, close, and in pause, you can have different menus like resume or go home and stuff like that, right? Close. Now I'm going to share with you this script. I hope you guys can see it. And I'm going to zoom in now. So this script will be shared in the description. And so in Unity, we've just made a new mono behavior script. So the first function is show panel. It takes the game object panel and it just activates it. And the second one, hide panel, it takes the panel and it basically hides it. In the third function is the toggle panel. This is basically, it's gonna take the function by itself and it's gonna activate it itself. So this function is rarely used, but these two would be most probably used. So you can actually use this script for your UI elements that are gonna hide and show. It makes your life a bit easier. And for those of you who would want this, you guys can take a screenshot and just type it in. That's it. Share that here. I'm gonna share the file and the link in the description as well. We'll have it in on our blog as well. If you go back, you can have as many panels as you have. I hope this has helped you guys, because it becomes pretty easy. You don't have to have script for every UI button and stuff like that, so you can play around with it. And in the next tutorial, I'm going to actually show you as well how you can put the button sound with one script that you just put on canvas. That's it. So all the buttons that come inside the canvas will get the sound automatically. And in the third tutorial after that, I'll teach you how you can use the sound manager to manage the sound. Let me share my game. The game that we're working on is this one, the Getaway Driver. So if I play it, you guys are going to hear the sound. Let me just select my settings so you guys can hear the sound of our desktop. So I'm going to click play. This is just Easter egg. I'm just going to reduce the desktop sound. So you see, I'll teach you how you guys can mute the sound. This is being done by the sound manager. I'm just working on this gameplay at the moment. So stick around, guys, and subscribe. Thank you for watching. So we have a lot of game development tutorials coming our way. Don't forget to subscribe, click the bell icon. And if you guys want to support us, join our Patreon. We've got a free group there, free tier. And with that, we have pay tiers as well. So you get one-on-one session with me. We give away our projects, a source code as well, so you can develop and design games. We teach you how to design 3D models, 2D model, Grease Pencil, Blender, Unity, a lot of programming stuff. It's a very good channel for you to learn. So I hope this has helped you. If you have got any questions, let me know so we can make tutorials and help you guys. Take care. Bye-bye. This is Ali Rathore from TechWrath TV signing out. Bye.